Okay, this is Clay. I'm here with Dan from JK Solar, and he's going to show us how they install an Enphase system. So it's 56 panels, correct, Dan?
Yes, it's 56 panels, all on one array facing the south.
Okay. So you want to tell us a little bit about the Enphase system, how it works? I hear it's a module under each solar panel.
It's microinverters transforming from DC to AC all the way down.
Right on the roof, and it goes into like a junction bus cable, all of them, and then that connects into the main.
Yeah, we just phase it right in.
So with a main junction breaker into the box.
So the DC stops right at the inverters, and it turns to AC right there, safer.
All right. So let's show me what you got going up here on the roof, okay?
Okay.
All right, thank you. Okay, tell us how you installed these, Dan.
All right, 2-3-inch lags, pushing the base plate right into the rafter. Glue around that, and then a built-in flashing with a piece of mastic over the leading edge so you don't get any kind of water penetration. And we set up a whole array of them. If you look up the roof there, this is quite a few. And that's the standoffs. And you attach the rail that the modules mount to that.
And then you just put the tile back over it, correct?
Yeah, and then we shave the bottom of the tile so everything lays flat.
And we don't get no leaks.
No leaks. That's the option. That's the...
All right. So explain this connection here to me, Dan.
Okay, well, first of all, the homeowner had a service that was too small, so we came out and changed the entire main panel.
Mm-hmm.
Finished it all up, painted it all in. This is the solar breaker. It's not hooked up yet.
Okay.
But we're bringing our solar wire around over here, coming through a fire department required disconnect.
Okay.
Which is on, that goes on every job. And then we pipe straight through the wall and put their load center inside, because they have multiple strings that we have to bring together.
Okay.
And so this will all be number 6 through here, and then we go around into the garage.
Okay.
All right, so this, we're on the other side of the wall, comes through from the disconnect, hooks up, then all the different solar breakers from all the different strings come down through the attic. On this particular job, they wanted it in the attic. So the wire run through the attic, and we'll be coming out on the roof with it and attaching to the strings.
This is the customer solar panels and junction cables for the Enphase. All right here. Waiting to be installed. This right here is an Enphase installation. Basically on an adobe roof. 56 panels. You can see they have the Enphase modules in. These have a little inverter for every panel. And these are the cables right here that we hook them into each panel. This is the main junction. This carries the AC voltage. DC goes in, AC voltage comes out. These cables connect to a junction box. This is our junction box right here, taking the AC down to the main panel.
Thank you.
So what are you doing today, Dan?
Wiring it up. Just got done wiring up the disconnect, running into the main service panel, getting the sub panel wired inside. Okay, this is the load center. This comes in from the other side where the disconnect is. And this is where all the strings, all the different four strings from the roof come down through the attic, come straight down the pipe, and we have separate breakers for each string. But that's where we combine the load center.
He throws big old bashes off the night before.
All right, these are the new integrated mid-clamps. These go between each one of the mods, and they've got teeth on the inside that bite into them so that everything's grounded. And these have teeth that bite onto the bottom and that fit inside the rail. It clamps in like that, and then these bite down on the mods so that everything's grounded without having to run a separate ground wire.
I see. That's your only run coming down, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. First box.
Looks like he's from Back to the Future. Is there 21
gigawatts.
You got it?
Yeah.
All right, I'll let go. It's almost too tall.
21 gigawatts. If we don't fix the flux capacitor, we'll never get back to 1987.
Made me nervous.
So this is the end phase string center.
There you go. Each string all labeled and wired. Get orange goes to orange.
Yeah, this gap. Can we get it? Yeah, you see that? dig or we could drop it.
So the system is completely wired up. We're just waiting for them to finish the mods on the roof. Does that mean they're done?